Okay, so welcome to Switch On. I'm very happy to be here today to share about our transformation story we had at La Redoute. And the theme I decided to share today, it was a full story from legacy mainframe to a cloud native architecture. And in fact, the question we'll try really to focus and answer through the story will be to answer how the application modernization we have implemented enable to support our business transformation. So before going into the detail, I will give a brief overview of La Redoute and to contextualize a bit the story I want to share today. So in fact, La Redoute is a much more French-based company, even if it has really expanded internationally and focused in Europe. It was known in all the head of the customers from the 50s to the 2000s, with a big catalog done every 6 months. And that was really a precursor in the distance selling model. And this was the image a lot of customers were used to. After the transformation we have done, so here we are after the years of transformation, we are much more focused on to be the preferred family and lifestyle platform. What you see in the background is the type of furnitures we are now able to produce and offer to our customers. We have also performed a drastic transformation of the business model and customer interaction, moving to a full omnichannel digital ways of communicating with customers. So here we put some examples of what we had to address. I would say the more traditional interaction on the web, application, tablet, etc., but also more recently, we are expanding on different type of interactions. So the company is still a creator of brands. So this is what I would say one prism of looking at the company. It's also now a company that is able to provide furnitures that we design internally and we offer to our customers that are quite different, and we are much more on the selling atmosphere and context. And here it's a bit the same. Here I want also to share that during the transformation, and we will come back to this a bit later on the architecture impact, we had to develop on top of developing new products such as ROM. We had to develop new business model, for example, selling in B2B. So this is one brand we built, La Redoute for Business, that we are now expanding. So we shifted clearly the type of interaction and customer. So adding B2B customer on top of the B2C existing segments. And we had also in parallel reopened stores in an omnichannel strategy. And this is something that was also quite new. And we had in the last two years, we had to open 60 stores. Enfin, it was not 2 years, it was 16 months. So it was quite a drastic challenge. And we are also present in a big mall. So just key figures before we enter into the detail of our modernization story. So to give a bit an idea of the size of the company, so we are a bit like mid-sized company, 750 million annual turnover. European market specificities is that in terms of, I would say, big major business processes, we are not only a digital platform and a marketplace, for example, we do have processes of internal product development and integration. We want really to be a curator marketplace. And we are also very developed on the, I would say, order processing and parcel shipping part. So we have like a three big areas of intervention in the business, and I will come back to this on the architecture. So, and we have big notoriety in France because this is where the company is born. We are one of the top 10 most visited websites, so we have huge stake on that part on the customer interactions. On the transformation we have done on digitalization, so we have now more than 96% of sales done on digital, whereas previously we were at about 50%. And we had also in the meanwhile accelerated a lot on the mobile part, an application that was not really the case about 5 years ago. And during the transformation, we had also to implement a really near real time processing, order processing to ship in within 2 hours. So this is what one challenge we had. And the point I was sharing to reopen stores and corner. So this was like what we were before, what we are today. And what I want to share with you now, focused on the question and the theme of today, it was a bit the story we did in terms of architecture and how it helps the business to transform. So Our starting point, and this is what I will start to explain, it was really a fight to survival with the monolith. So I will explain a bit more in detail what does that mean at that time. So globally, we had different business driver for the business depending on the context when we started. So on the left, the key business driver for France was to expand remote selling model that was working and looking for economies of scale for a model that was validated. And the system was like, so it's a very simplistic scheme, but globally it was that. We had a big mainframe that was supported all the remote selling operations. In parallel, we wanted to develop internationally, and the drivers were a bit different. We wanted to deploy fast the models that we had validated in France, and we are more looking for economies of speed. And this is why, for example, we accepted to have a specific back office and system for each international country. Because maybe what is a bit counterintuitive in my scheme is that each box of each country was a different, I would say, IT architecture, system, and processes that was set up in place. So we'll come back to this part of the story and modernization later on, but this was our starting point. Then what happened is that we enter into the web era from the 2000s, and we had to implement e-commerce and web focus. So at that time, it was merely focused on web interactions. So we ended up, as we wanted to be fast and to reuse and to be pluggable on the existing back office, so to implement on the front one specific platform for France, because it was really specific, etc. And also what we don't see in the scheme is that the organization of our company was completely separated for France and international. So this explains why we had two differences here. And then on the international part, there was a bit different brands and websites. So this explains why we had different front-end architecture that had, unfortunately, to cope with the variety of back-end we see in the scheme. So what happened at that time, we had a really first warning sign in 2013, is that for France, for example, we had a big project to deliver 24-hour parcel delivery for our customer, and we took one year, of a very painful project to be able to deliver that. We were starting to have very high legacy IT costs on the mainframe, on the front-end, etc. And we were still slower to deliver. And overall, IT has really become a bottleneck for the business, so being slower and providing less business value overall. On the international part, we had an external factor that changed, that the competition starting to increase drastically. On our side also, we started to have much more complex releases because due to the complexity of having different systems that had to work together. And also globally the operating model, we had an unfit because we wanted to have a unification operating model between international, but behind the scene, we had different systems and processes. So the key focus we had at that time in terms of transformation for survival, because at that time the company was losing like 50 million in EBITDA for 600 million turnover, so we are really in a bad situation. So we wanted to accelerate on the digitalization and becoming an e-commerce pure player. We had to accelerate drastically the cycle of collection. So as we see in the first slide on the big catalog every 6 months, we had to kill it and accelerate by a factor of 10. Our order processing also had to be completely reviewed from the IT system and the physical processes and the logistic processes. And we had also to gain and develop new business model to get younger and diverse customers. So here we had big focus in terms of what we had to do in terms of architecture. So I simplified a bit the major idea here, but globally, on the e-commerce part, we had really to accelerate our capacity to deliver web and our performance of the e-commerce shop. And globally, overall, we had the big stakes to be able to modernize and decouple more clearly our function for the business in order to provide the key focus that are on top. So just as a quick, I would say, map that we used and that I personally use in terms of application modernization techniques is that we have always from bottom to top, increased complexity and impact and value we can provide to the business. And three major categories. So from the bottom, technology, architecture, or functions. And the more we go on top, the more we accumulate, in fact, the modernization we can do, and then I listed the specific choices that are possible. So, and we go from encapsulating the existing application to on top a complete replace of the application. So here I also did a summary of the exercise we did on aligning our business and IT stakes at that time. So here what I put is clearly business stakes in terms of business fit of the IT system, business value delivered and the agility we were having, and then from an IT perspective, what were the costs? Were we looking purely and merely on an IT cost perspective, the IT complexity and the IT risk involved with the platform? And we have four layers of analysis. So only the e-commerce, so for the France part, the back office, and then the same for international. And at that time, in terms of context and priorities, we see that the line with the major problem was our back office for France that was really limiting the business transformation and value, and it was also a huge risk, and we were starting also to be quite red for all the web French part. International at that time was a bit less in terms of business volume overall, and it was a much more agile than the French part. So this is why we decided to focus on the red and amber part first. So, and if we took the key element of context we had at that time, is that the France business volume was 70% of the overall business. We were in a huge transformation plan and reduction of FTE due to the transformation imperative. So we were cutting by half the overall number of FTE in the company. And we had to redo completely the web and the backbone for France, including the, we'd say, business part. So how does it translate in IT context is that we focus heavily on the fresh system first approach. We focus also on the cost reduction focus for IT because the company was in like, we need to get back to profitability, and we were in really protective and survival approach. And we decided so to start it replacing completely the web and back office with our transformation priorities. The key constraints we were having at that time were that we were transforming France, but we had issues and we had to manage at the same time the operation and evolution of international. There is always like legal and regulation we need to cope with. We had also to choose between rebuilding and replacing, and this was something not easy because as we lose half of the company, we lose also a lot of interlocutors and knowledge to help us if we want, for example, to rebuild an application or replace it. It's hard to get people that give the business rules we want to implement and business function. And then in the last part is that we had a big plan to get rid globally overall of the mainframe due to the huge CapEx and OPEX impact. So what we decided from our starting point, it was to apply different modernization techniques on the selected context. So if we start on top on the front part, we decided to simplify and to converge to a single platform. We had to make that choice. And we took a choice to take the one that was more agile and more easily adaptable and modularizable for France and the other countries. And we replaced completely the other one, the existing ones that are in gray. So a huge project on that part to converge the experience. And then on the mainframe, we started a rebuilding effort that we'll explain after how it started to be transformed. And on the international, we just approached with a refactoring approach. So the picture we ended up after this some years and months of transformation, it was that we simplified the front overall with web and application. We had also developed a marketplace integration with new components, so out of the mainframe. And we started to have all the, I would say, more the backbone of the company, so stock, parcel management, promotion, shipping, etc., on a distributed system, so more on the order-to-cash aspect. And we also implemented a much more robust core financial platform. And we didn't touch a lot the international back office because we had already huge work to do at that time. So what was possible to achieve and the value for the business at that time is that as we were having a single platform, we were able to accelerate clearly the cycle of evolution because we remove all the double or triple effort that was done. With that, we were able to accelerate the delivery of the system and get rid of legacy part from an IT perspective. And we were able with that to liberate the IT investment we had for more profitable opportunities and development. For the refactoring aspect, We are much more able to focus on accelerating the delivery and also simplifying the model because we started more for scratch and for simpler rules that were not inherited all the existing complexity. And it was an advantage of having like new people working with us on that. And in terms of rebuilding application, another aspect we got, as we get more modern application interfaces and usage, we are able to globally increase the adoption of application and digitalization within the company with ease of use, speed of the interfaces and lower training requirement. And overall, it helps us for IT to reduce the legacy risk on the IT system. So, and if we take an example of the web part, those are some type of KPI we are able to reach because we really focused on harmonizing. So from an initial take to migration to a common platform and then to the optimization. We did a lot of work also on the quality assurance process and the lean value stream, etc., to be able to drastically accelerate and to have at the end only a single mobile first 100% responsive application and website. So, and here, just to know that we were able to also have a very performant website in the top three of the major website at that time. So, we were also to reach, I would say, performance objective of the operation and not only in business features. And here it's an example of the new warehouse we had to build and the new business model we implemented. And the warehouse is one of the most automated in Europe for the retail and fashion activity, equivalent to the one done by Amazon in Europe. So, and then what happened at that time is that we had passed the phase to say we are able to survive. We are not anymore in a to stay or die situation. So we can be a bit less protective, not completely open and I would say aggressive on the market. So I will share here what happened during that period. So a big focus we had was to move to a new channel strategy because we focused a lot on simplifying the operating model and going back to a fully digital model. But we didn't address the stores part and physical part. And what we see is that we need that to have a more concrete link with the customer. As in parallel, we started to develop the furnitures and etc. We needed to have a bit more physical presence with the customer. And so this was the first pillar. So moving to the omnichannel part. We had also developed some business ideas that had proved to develop some really millions of sales. So we started to wanted to accelerate on that, such as home and furnitures, marketplace and dropshipping model. And we wanted also to complement the offer of Redoute, not only with product, but with services. So some example here, but personalization, fidelization on some specific and tailored delivery or payment services that are really differentiating for the customer. So like take a delivery in a specific hour, when you buy a bed, we take back your old one, etc. So really added value services here. So our starting point at that time was the picture I shared before. So globally, we had this picture. We did a similar exercise as before on like a gap analysis, etc. So I did a simplified view here, a bit different because we had much more applications. So we did the application portfolio analysis in detail. Here, it's only a summarized view. But globally, the main issue we were having, and it was less, I would say, parallelized between business and IT. But we were globally on the IT part, we did not really add the capabilities to provide services for the business. It was really an architecture built to integrate products, sell them and ship them from the warehouse. It was not built to sell services. It was not done also to have omnichannel interaction and manage the stores. And also not that much for the home part. We are more used to selling fashion. And on the IT part, we are still having a bit of monolith cost, I would say, and weight, both for France and international. And then we see back services and international started to be a problem in terms of maintenance. So what we decided to focus at the time, based on the priorities that are summarized, so all the new features in terms of services, we decided to get rid of all what was existing on the mainframe and to build them from scratch because they were much more added value and completely new to build. The other ones that had to evolve, such as payment and delivery, we take them out of the mainframe and we put them in a new layer that were build and buy approach, but much more, I would say, scalable and modern. And we also take the opportunity at that time to start to really provides a similar function for international. So this is what we did on those services. And we decided also to address a specific part on shipping and transport, because if we wanted to offer delivery services, we had also to have completely rebuild and modernize the shipping and transport aspect. So this is why this was treated at the same time. And the last thing we decided, so the replatform box in the blue, in the dark blue in the bottom left, it was that we were still having the mainframe for, I would say, a significant cost during the year, but for not that much business value. It was really all the function. So what we decided, it was to port, to do replatforming of our mainframe to open stack, so like Postgre, Linux, etc. And it enabled us to get rid of completely of the cost of the mainframe and to have a really cheaper entry ticket, passing it to the cloud on a specific technologies. And here we managed to kill the mainframe like that. So, and what happened in terms of business result, etc. So some examples in terms of services, we managed with implementation of new services, even we still had to cope with the legacy, etc. Deploy fidelization programs that enable us to reach 500k subscribers in 1 year. We are also able to accelerate clearly the ratio and the TTR on the mobile app, for example, up to 8%, which is quite strong. We had all 4% on the web part, and on the mobile and application, we managed to increase to 8%. And overall on the IT part, so we managed also to progress. So it's a never-ending job, but we managed to progress clearly on simplifying the IT landscape. On the rebuild part, we are also able to provide and offer the specific tailored delivery services for our customer and cope with the delivery. And we are also able to simplify globally the system and liberate again IT investment for more added value development. And the replatforming, yes, here we save a lot of bucks, I would say, for with the mainframe removal overall. So in the last part, what we are working right now is that we have a big focus on evolving to a digital platform, huge tech and transformation. So we need to develop digital experiences, build and transform our, deliver our vision to be the preferred family and lifestyle platform for the families. Be really a platform approach with all the connectivity, integration with the partners, the customer, etc., and provide added value services. And we need to really be much more aggressive right now and support the business growth. The limiting factor we are having right now are the interactions that are really tied to web and store, and they are not really omnichannel. Our system was built around, I would say, a single customer focus in B2C and also B2B, but it was not built around the family aspect. So this is what we need to do, is really to start to evolve our architecture to reflect in our system the family and to be able to capture data and provide additional services and insights. On our digital platform, we need to treat the aspect of openness and integration with the rest of the ecosystem. So here are a lot of buzzwords around API management, API, etc., but this is what we will be working on. And on the business growth, we had to develop and to streamline specific processes like the push of the product and services to the partners, but also more overall to deploy all the specific business model to international. And here it's a big major aspect we have to deal with. So, and does that translate in our transformation? It's a bit what I was sharing. So we have those four pillars that are right now our main focus of transformation. And if we map it a bit to our modernization strategy, so we have a bit different approach. On top left is that we need to create new interaction with, a partner and developer platform. We need to re-architecture our web and app platform to be really an omnichannel strategy and to have common services between all our digital interactions, so all the top part between the create and the architect part. We need to rebuild and replace some specific aspect of our marketplace to be able to incorporate and scale on an international part. We want also to evolve drastically our fidelization order, customer and parcel management, because this is core to be able to deliver the new services. And here we choose an aspect of rebuilding. And we want to replace the parts that are really right now too much, too legacy, old, and I would say they need really modernization to be fitting with what we will change on the left, because in fact, everything we change on the left is impacting at the end the revenue recognition and the type of processes. And on international, it's more that it's legacy system we need to migrate. So right now, this is our monetization strategy we have decided to follow. So, so I have some takeaways I wanted to share out of this experience. So we had really, and this is a key focus for us always, to balance business and IT drivers. So it's never like always business or only IT drivers. And in the first part on our story, we were too much on the IT part and we suffered a lot from that, to have too much IT-led initiative with a clear lack of business involvement. And for me, it was really something we had to pay back later on in rework and changes, etc. In terms of monetization techniques, what we see is that we always need to start with a big picture, so business objective, big application map, application portfolio analysis, and really make choice in specific context on what to do. And the choices can be really different depending on the exact problematic in the context. And then something for me that is a bit sometimes counterintuitive is that we were always used to like the big is the better, etc. So we need always to like converge everything, rationalize all the aspects, and it's better to have everything centralized. The reality for me is that, again, in specific context, it can be best to accept to be fast, and we come back to the objective, to gain economies of speed and instead of economies of scale, for example. And we need to accept some time to buy specific services or to accept during some years to rely on external partner for specific things or do different things from France and international. So again, for me, there's no like black or white solution on 100%, 0% solution extreme. For me, it's always a question of balance. And more important than that, expliciting the trade-off, I think for me, the clear work of architecture is to be able to explicit the major trade-off of decision for business and IT. So, and this is what I wanted to share today at Switch On. So I hope it was interesting, and I would be happy to share in the question on the room.